hinge movement. So if the athlete starts thinking about the knees, they're usually going to mess up the bar path by bending their knees a little bit too much. If the hips go back, the hips come through. That's basically what their mantra is, what I tell them to think about when they deadlift. Put the tension in the hamstrings, because if they're feeling in their lower back or their quads or somewhere other than their hamstrings dominantly, they're probably doing the lifting correctly. Those are cues I'll use after, obviously, instilling the correct mechanics of, you know, flat back, neutral spine, the entire lift, maintaining the glide stabilization and all that. I can't do it unbroken, and I know I should be able to, but I have to be smart and pacing the handstand push-ups, because if I do the first 21 unbroken, I'll burn out. I've done it before. I've only done this a couple times, and I'm still trying to find a better way to pace it. So that's today's goal, is to experiment with the pacing. I'm going to break up the first set of 21, 12, and 9, I think. And then I'm going to try and do the 15 9s unbroken, see if that nets me a better, faster time. So we'll see. When you get into a workout like Diane, you need to get into a rhythm, timing that touch and go rep at the bottom, not necessarily bouncing, but your hips should be at their end point as the bar comes into contact with the ground, and then you just pull the hips back through to stand up fully. There's a whole bunch of flexibility tests that I run people through before I even like get them doing handstand push-ups. I'll try and get everybody into a handstand, but until they can show, like, full shoulder mobility is a huge issue with a lot of new people, and a handstand push-up is just gonna be that much more difficult if they can't open up their shoulder all the way. So handstand push-ups are typically all about positioning. I don't really teach the kip. I let the athlete find that on their own. I'd rather build strength in a static, in a press, rather than a kipping press. With the competitors, I'll go into a little bit more kipping, but usually they just find that on their own.